Oh, look at it in the back there. It's a little baby sand boa.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog on this absolutely gorgeous fall morning here in Michigan. I hope the start of your day is going to be absolutely incredible. As for me, I know it's going to be an insanely awesome day, but also extremely hectic. We have a couple days before we leave for the Tinley Park Show in Chicago, so we have a lot to get prepared for. I also have a kind of fun meeting with Discovery Channel today. I'll keep you guys posted on how that goes, but there certainly is going to be a lot on my plate today. And on my plate, I basically just mean there's a lot of work to get ready. We have tons of babies to set up. We got things still hatching, almost done with that season, but we also just have a ton to prepare because we're going to be gone for a couple days and we've got to make sure that everything is in good shape. But one really cool thing happened this morning is this. Dun, 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 dun. What you say? Oh, it's a sambo. How nice is that? But let's take a deeper look in here. Oh, look at it in the back there. It's a little baby sand boa. Oh, they are so cute. Oh my gosh, look at. And look at how cool it is. You know, these are rough scale sand boas. And you can see, look at this baby here compared to the adult. They're actually like little carbon copies of the mom. So let's see what happens here. This girl was loaded up. So I'm assuming she's gonna have a bunch of babies, but let's see what we've got in here. Look at, there's babies here, there's babies over here. Oh, look at all these babies. There's a couple infertile ova. These are just infertile, like basically eggs. They call them ova. But everything else looks good. Look at all these little babies here. Oh gosh, look at how cool. Oh, there's another infertile ova here. Oh, so there's three bad ones, but these other ones. Oh, mama, what's the matter? What's the matter? Okay, let's see. Oh, there's another one. Oh, this litter actually wasn't as good as I thought. Let's go ahead and get a tub and I'll go ahead and pull these babies. Okay, let's go see how many babies are in here. All right, we got this one little guy here. Oh, look at how cute they are. Here's two. This one's got a chubby belly. Oh my gosh, that's two. Here's three. Oh, look at that one. Watch out, mama. I see some stuff moving. There's four. And five. Oh, where are you at? Five. So far, five babies. Let's see if we got anything else in here. Five babies. Come on, you gotta have more than five babies, hon. Oh, that might be it. Yep, it looks like five babies is the number, which is kind of a small litter for that girl because she was so loaded, but you gotta remember she had four infertiles as well. But look at how cute these little babies are. And again, they're just little carbon copies of the mom. Now, a lot of snakes when they hatch are a little bit different, and then as they grow, they change into their adult color. But in this case, I mean, these guys are literally just little carbons of their parents. I mean, they are so cute. And these samboas stay a little bit smaller than the Kenyan samboas, and they typically have smaller litters as well, typically anywhere from 6 to 10. So theoretically, she had five live babies and she had four infertile. So she had nine kind of total if you look at it that way. But anyways, five babies and they are all beautiful and look really good. Look at that pattern on that one. That one is really cool. All right, I love little live babies. Getting baby snakes is always an absolutely great way to start the day, and I hope that you guys have an amazing day as well. I know I have a really hectic day, but it's gonna be absolutely amazing. The next thing up on my docket is actually to open up this box right here. That's right, a friend of mine actually got some animals and asked if we could just trade some stuff, which I think is always awesome because, you know, hey, I get to get some good stuff, he gets to get some good stuff, we all are happy, we get some cool animals exchanged. So again, I'm not even quite sure what he sent me, but I know that they're ball pythons, so what do you say we go ahead and open up this box? So it's always exciting when you get a box of snakes and you're not even sure what's in it. And you know, I know that a lot of people are always like, Brian, you always get so much stuff. And that's just kind of part of running a reptile business, you know. Obviously, the vast majority of stuff that we sell, we produce ourselves. But there's certainly, you know, times that we have to buy new stock, so we're getting new gene pools in. There's also times we buy and sell from reputable people. So it's kind of fun to be able to always unbox things for you guys. And I hope you guys don't mind and don't think it's getting boring. Go ahead and comment down below and let me know what you think. If you think it's cool that I unbox snakes, or if you're like, all right, Brian, I've had enough, I don't need to see any more unboxing. Regardless, let me know what you think. I always get excited about it. So but anyways, let's see what's in this. There's more paper than there are snakes. right. So, oh, there's a whole bunch of little bags. Look at all these little bags. So I'm just going to go ahead and kind of highlight some of the stuff that I think is really cool. This is actually a pastel hidden gene WOMA. Now, the hidden gene WOMA is interesting. It's another mutation that is allelic with some stuff, and it produces something that's called a soul sucker. So they can be really cool. So the hidden gene WOMA in itself isn't always the most incredible looking animal, but some of its offspring are really spectacular. Okay, so let's see what's in this bag right here. All right, and that's really cool. That is actually a hidden gene WOMA right there. And you can see the kind of really busy patterning that it has. And that's basically what it is. You know, I guess it's a little bit similar to the GHI, but it doesn't make things as dark, but it really busies up pattern. And again, when you breed it to certain things, it becomes allelic, again, like lesser produced. Is the soul sucker, and there's a whole bunch of, I mean, it's a really cool gene, and one that I don't work much with, so this one will probably stick around here and be a future breeder. All right, so this one here is actually another hidden gene WOMA, but this one happens to be an Enchi, and you all know that I love the Enchi stuff, and when it mixes with things, it's really awesome. So this is what a hidden gene WOMA Enchi looks like. Look at how cool that is. Again, that Enchi gene just kind of fades stuff out, and it just makes it a little bit more bright and more interesting. So there's a bunch of snakes in here that are really nice, but I'm not going to show you guys like pastel het pies, and there's a pastel hidden gene WOMA that we kind of showed you. There's a lot of hidden gene WOMA stuff in it, which is pretty cool because I don't work with a lot of the hidden gene WOMA stuff. So I do want to show you a handful of other animals here. This one happens to be a hidden gene WOMA yellow belly, which is pretty interesting. And you can kind of see how the yellow belly affects the hidden gene WOMA. Again, that yellow belly just sends like kind of more firing and blushing in the sides. And again, this is kind of on the path to something that they call an inferno ball python. So you need this, the hidden gene WOMA yellow belly, to get to an inferno. That is a really gorgeous animal. And again, look at how busy pattern these hidden gene WOMAs are. Then we have the calico hidden gene WOMA, which is kind of an interesting kind of mix. This one doesn't look very hidden gene WOMA to me. The calico here, you can certainly see, is that kind of white that comes out in the sides. And I've shown you babies that were like really pink in the sides, and that's what happens, is that as they grow, the pink turns to a white. But this one isn't very busy patterned. I almost wonder if this is just a calico. I don't really see hidden gene WOMA in this one, and that happens sometimes. Sometimes when you produce, you think that it might be something and it's not. We'll have to see if we breed it out, see if there's anything other than calico in it. But to me, it looks just like a calico. And last animal I'm going to show you in this shipment is one that I was really excited about when I saw the bag, because I really like the dark genes and the chocolate gene in particular. And we were the first ones in the country with the chocolate gene, so it's kind of special and near and dear to me. So this one right here is actually a chocolate hidden gene WOMA, which I think has some pretty interesting potential, because the chocolate gene is a codominant gene and has a super form. So I wonder what a super chocolate hidden gene is. And then when you start mixing into stuff like lesser and the inferno stuff and so on like that, could get some really interesting combinations. So regardless, you know, this was a cool shipment of stuff. It certainly got me into hidden gene WOMA stuff. Again, I had a few animals, but not very much. So now I have quite a few more that I can hang on, and I'll probably sell a couple hidden gene WOMA things, this because he sent me a bunch of it. But man, these things are really cool. Let me know down in the comments which one of the hidden gene WOMAs you like best, because I think they're all cool, and there are some really nice bright ones, but I kind of am, you know, a little bit partial to the chocolate hidden gene WOMA. Okay guys, 1 second for some real-time talk between us. You know, I posted a couple videos with the anaconda and the cowrie tick where I kind of surprised Lori by, number one, not telling her I was getting them, and number two, surprised her on film with me getting them. And in retrospect, there was a few kind of nasty comments. And listen, that's going to happen no matter what you do. When you put yourself out there on social media, you're going to get people that say negative things. I don't know why. I've never in my life thought I would post something negative, but it happens all the time. That's part of it. And we don't really, you know, I ignore that stuff for the most part. Although I do try to listen to you guys. But it did bring up a point that, number one, I wanted to say that I think it was a little wrong of me that I posed Lori in that light. You know, the truth is that, you know, everything that I have has been because Lori has supported me over the last quarter of a century. I mean, she has been my right-hand person, my best friend, everything I could ever ask for. And sure, she's my yin to my yang, right? Like, I'm a person that just wants everything. I want to, you know, buy stuff. I want to get more. I want to get more. She's like the voice of reason that kind of keeps me in check. If I didn't have those checks and balances, quite frankly, I would be out of control, and I probably wouldn't be nearly as successful as we've been over the years, because she's the person that kind of keeps the bolts all put together. And she really does run the show here. You know, I tell people that all the time. I'm just a passionate animal. animal guy and kind of the visionary, but the truth is she's the one that kind of runs all of the nuts and bolts of BHB and keeps things going. So with that said, it kind of bummed me out a little bit that there's some people said that she's always negative and that she's not happy, because the truth is that we have a great relationship. We love each other. We have a great time together. We joke around constantly. And it was really my fault that I kind of framed her in a way that it made her look like she was mean, and I apologize for that. I don't want you guys to have that vision of Lori, because that's not who she is, and so I just wanted to take a second and kind of explain that. Is that okay? So there you are. There was a little chat for us. Thanks, guys. You know, everybody always asks me to update my blue tongue skinks, and this guy is absolutely amazing. I mean, look at that tongue. How incredible is that? But you know what? I always try to stay positive, guys, but this has a rather interesting story that is a little bit negative, but it turns out that the negative turned positive, and I'm going to explain what that means. I actually had a couple female Centralians, and these are what they call Taliqua multifasciata. Very few of these in the country, and fortunately, I got them from a guy named Bill Brandt, who got them from another person that had been in the country for 20 or 30 years, and they're probably only two of a handful in the entire country of legal animals, that is. Regardless, I needed a male, obviously, because I didn't have one, so I had a guy over in Europe that had a male that I was going to trade for a female. We ended up sending the female over to the guy, and then he ended up never showing up, so he never did the trade. And then my exporter shipped back the supposed female that was twice the size, and guess what it was? They sent me a half-size male. Of course, they thought that they were somehow screwing me over, obviously, because they took my female and they gave me a male in exchange without me knowing, which isn't the righteous thing to do, I might add. But ironically enough, they did me a favor because I needed a male, and that was what the trade was for in the beginning. So it all worked out and everything is good, and with any luck, I might have some little baby Centralians in the future. Regardless, we are gearing up for a really amazing blue tongue skink year this next year coming up, so I couldn't be more excited. And again, people ask me about the blue tongues all the time, so I figured I'd talk a little bit about them and show one of my favorite animals, the Centralian blue tongue skinks. All right, guys, so I am going to wrap up another busy and hectic day sitting down here with my buddy RJ, and of course Bowser is underneath here, and we are just going to relax for a little bit and just kind of decompress. This is my zen area, people. This is where I come at the end of the day and just go, oh, I can just enjoy looking at the beautiful pond, looking at RJ and interacting. So, and it's been a few days since I've been in the pond, so I'm going to have to pull the shorts out here pretty soon and go in the pond and play with RJ a little bit. Regardless, it's amazing this time of the year. It's busy as all get out, but I love it to death. Every day is so challenging, but also so exciting. I hope that you guys have an amazing day, and I hope that the rest of your day, whenever you happen to be watching it, is absolutely phenomenal. Your support means the world to me, and I love you guys to death. Can you do me a couple favors, please? Can you hit that like button right down there? Also, turn the post notifications on. Make sure to be kind to somebody, and I promise I'm going to see you tomorrow.